getting the loan at a lower interest rate and investing at the higher interest rate. So yen carry trade, I've already explained in the yesterday's lecture what is the yen carry trade. I will summarize little bit. Like, if somebody is getting the loan at a lower interest rate and investing at the higher interest rate, so basically if you get the loan at a low interest rate, say 5%, and you get the investment opportunity where you will get the 10%, so 5% will be your profit. Now there is an article, as you must have heard, Japanese government has increased their interest rates. Now I want to explain you one thing. Interest rate works different for the different people. Like, for example, for the investor, like who wants to invest in any of the country, what he will consider, interest rate should be higher or low? Please try to write in the comment section. I want to see your view on it. So investor will want higher interest rate, as if he will get the higher interest rate, he will get the higher returns. On the other side, if there is a borrower who is raising the loan, he must be wanting the lower interest rate, as he has to pay that interest rate. So you have understood one thing: borrower will want the lower interest rate and investor will want higher interest rate in any of the economy. What was the scenario in Japan? Japan has maintained basically low interest rate for the long period of time. So what was happening in Japan? Japanese people get a loan at lower interest rate from the Japan. Now they will not basically invest in the Japan because there is low interest rate in the economy. What they were doing, they were going to the Asian markets or the Western markets for the investment. Why? Because to get the higher returns, as there were high interest rate. So you must have understood this topic. This is called as yen carry trade. So basically yen is Japanese currency. They are carrying their money from the Japan at the lower interest rate and then investing in the other countries to get the higher interest rates and the higher returns. This was happening. This is called as carry trade maybe, or the yen carry trade. I hope you have understood this topic. Now why this is in news? As Japanese government has kept the low interest rate for the long period of time, now Japan has increased their interest rates. Now due to this, in the stock market, investors are basically withdrawing their money to invest in Japan. So this is called, there is a huge outflow from the Asian markets. So there could be a recession in the Asian markets due to this. And already we are seeing recession in the US. Warren Buffett, the huge investor, has withdrawn a huge money from the stock market. And there is a selling pressure on the stock market. This way, the investment will be lower in the coming days. And you have understood the due to the increased interest rate by the Japan, there is a selling pressure on the stock market and there is a withdrawal of money of the investment from the Asian market. This is going back to the Japan. In fact, for your homework, I want you to read about the taper tantrum. Read about it. It has been seen in 2012 and in COVID-19, and UPSC has framed the prelims question over this, how to maintain this. And in fact, this way foreign currency outflow is also there. So there will be two of the impacts. In the basically, if any of the economy increase their interest rate, there could be outflow of the money. You have understood it. In response, there could be a chance RBI or any of the central bank of other economies, they have to increase their interest rates to stop those investors to go out of the market. So the basic concept was, you should understand why the high interest rate is wanted by the investor and why the low interest rate is wanted by the borrower. So in response to the Japanese increased interest rates, other central banks will also increase their interest rates. Now, till now, you must have understood. Now moving further, how we will link this to the monetary policy. I have already told you what is the link with the financial market. Now, if there is an interest rate increasing interest rate by the central bank, basically whether there is an increase or decrease in interest rate by the central bank, it is regulated by the monetary policy. So what is RBI or any of the central bank is doing? They are basically regulating the money supply. What is the money supply there? Like, what is the money in circulation in any of the economy? That is being regulated by the central bank, by the monetary policy. We have understood, if any of the central bank increase the interest rate, then the other economies also have to increase interest rate if they want to stop that outflow of the foreign currency. So increase in interest rate by the central bank or the decrease, it is regulated by the monetary policy. There is a scenario, if interest rate is increased, you have to understand, please focus for a 1 minute, you will understood one of the most important topic. For example, interest rate is increased, it means there is decrease in money supply. How there is a decrease in money supply? Because the interest rate has been increased, it means there will be costly loans. I have already told you, borrowings should be made at low interest rate. So increased borrowing cost. Increased borrowing cost, it means there will be less money supply. Less money with the public. You can think of the scenario, if you have more money, you will obviously go to the market to spend. There will be more demand, but if you have less money, then there will be less demand in the economy. If there is a less demand, then what the rule says? There will be less supply. Why? Why there will be less supply? Because producers will not produce as there is a less demand, but obviously it takes time. There will be a huge time lag between these, but the short term goal would be, it would decrease the inflation. As less money with the public, they will demand less. So there is an inverse relationship with the demand and the price, you know already. Obviously, if there are 10 people to buy one thing, they will be ready to pay more. So with the decreased money supply, there will be less inflation in the short term, but in the long term, it could impact the less supply and less growth. That's why it is always said, for the monetary policy, there is basically huge dilemma to maintain between the inflation and the growth. But in the monetary policy in India, we are targeting the inflation. That's why inflation targeting has been given to the Monetary Policy Committee. You need to read about the Monetary Policy Committee. It has been asked in the prelims. That way, you must have understood the whole scenario. I hope I have tried to summarize all the whatever is happening in the very simple terms. You need to understand first what is yen carry trade, then yen carry trade due to the Japanese interest, increased interest rate, how the outflow is happening, and it could impact the Asian markets. Then what we have understood, it will have impact on the monetary policy and how the monetary policy will try to make a balance between the inflation and the growth. I hope everything is clear to you.